We are constantly surrounded by communication. In many instances, a person or company is trying to convince others to buy, believe, motivate, or inspire. This is called rhetoric. The assumption behind rhetoric is that you can be convinced. Rhetoric is used to do the convincing. As a side note, rhetoric typically involves elements of truth, but rhetoric cannot be relied upon to present the complete truth. Several styles and definitions of rhetoric are discussed and studied, but Greek philosopher Aristotle offers one of the simplest explanations of rhetoric. He describes three different types or modes of rhetoric. Those are logos, ethos, and pathos. Logos relies on the logic of an argument to convince others. When facts, studies, and statistics are used to convince others to think or believe a claim, logos is at work. Ethos depends on the character and reliability of the speaker to convince others. If the speaker is experienced in a field or educated, you may be more likely to believe them. If I tell you, "Hey, I think your alternator needs to be fixed," would you believe me? Probably not. I don't have any experience fixing cars. But if my dad, who has extensive experience with vehicles and worked at Ford Motor Company for 25 years, tells you to check out the alternator, his diagnosis is likely to be spot on. That's also why Nike hires a well-known MVP like LeBron James to sell their shoes instead of little old me. Pathos is probably the most frequently used mode of rhetoric, not only in our personal lives as we communicate with our friends and family, but it's also becoming much more common in news and media as well. Pathos intentionally engages people's emotions in order to convince them. As a side note, be cautious of anyone who relies entirely on pathos to convince you. Emotions are not a reliable decision-making tool. An easy way to remember Aristotle's modes of rhetoric is to insert the modes of rhetoric into the diagram for rhetorical situation. Remember, a rhetorical situation is any act of communication between people. Rhetorical situation includes a messenger who presents a message to a target audience. Inserting Aristotle's modes of rhetoric, we have the logic of the message itself, the character or reliability of the messenger, the emotional involvement of the target audience. For instance, in Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s famous "I Have a Dream" speech, Dr. King is the messenger, his dream of freedom and equality for all Americans is the message, and American citizens as well as the U.S. legislature is the target audience. As the messenger, does the character of Dr. King make him a reliable messenger? Yes. He's not only a black citizen, but he's also an educated minister. Does the message employ logic and facts? Yes. Dr. King references foundational American documents such as the Constitution and the Emancipation Proclamation. Does Dr. King engage the emotions of the target audience? Oh yes. His mention of children pulls at the heartstrings of every parent, and his repetition of key phrases such as "I have a dream" and "Let freedom ring" are meant to inspire and motivate his audience to action. Not every orator is as reliable and convincing as Dr. King. So when you're bombarded by rhetoric on all sides, use your critical thinking skills to decide for yourself whether or not you should believe those claims. Created using Powtoon.